The brain is estimated to have more than a trillion neuron connections. Modern technology can provide us with a glimpse of what that looks like. This image was created using neural barcoding technology called BARCeq, developed by the Zeder Lab at Cold Spring Harbor Laboratory. BARCeq tracks the movements of tens of thousands of neurons in some of the brain's key smell processing centers. But what do these neurons and neural pathways do? How do we get from here to here? Scientists still don't know for sure how the brain smelling powers work, but thanks to BARCeq, they're beginning to get a better idea. To help illustrate how these brain circuits might function and how they're wired together, CESHL Associate Professor Florin Albany and Professor Alexei Kulikov got together with science illustrator Gil Costa. This illustration shows how CESHL neuroscientists think the smelling process may be coordinated in the brain. The different colored islands represent key brain regions of the olfactory system. CESHL scientists think that each region processes and decodes specific kinds of information, represented here by various icons. So, what might happen in your brain when you smell something? Let's check it out with the help of our pal, Odie, the odor guide. When we encounter a smell, neurons are triggered in our olfactory bulb. This part of the brain sends out information in parallel to several different regions of our olfactory system. One important stop along this journey is the piriform cortex. This central processing hub is the largest region in the olfactory cortex. Here, at the front of this island, in the anterior piriform cortex, we find an antenna, an observatory, and a fruit stand. Note that these symbols are also located in the anterior olfactory nucleus, in matching yellow. These brain regions may be responsible for perceiving smells, decoding their identity, concentration, and time and information. Neurons taking these neural pathways may help detect the smell. And ultimately determine what it is. Another route on Odie's journey takes us deeper into the piriform cortex, to the posterior piriform cortex, and to another region called the cortical amygdala. Scientists think that these areas may be responsible for interpreting valence, whether a smell is pleasant or, well, stinky. How we interpret smells in the wild is very important. Good smells, illustrated here by berries, could be connected to pleasant, hunger-satisfying tastes. While potentially toxic or dangerous smells, represented here by bears, could tell us to steer clear. One more stop on Odie's journey takes us to the posterior piriform cortex, and another brain region called the lateral entorhinal cortex. The roads and vehicle icons represent how these regions may connect olfactory and spatial information, and help to plan actions our brain may take in response to smells. They can help determine where a smell is coming from, its direction, and proximity, and can trigger our fight or flight response. Scientists used to think that the brain's smell process was mostly random, uncoordinated, and highly distributed. But now, thanks to BARCeq, we are beginning to understand the logic behind this complicated process. It turns out that the ways neurons project out from different parts of the piriform cortex to certain other regions of the brain is in sync with how they're projected to those same regions from the olfactory bulb. By decoding the logic of brain circuits, BARCeq is providing neuroscientists with a better understanding of how the brain actually works, which could someday lead to new treatments for neuropsychiatric conditions, from Alzheimer's to depression. To find out more, visit cshl.edu/research/neuroscience.